Ryan Brown here after Wingate Bulldogs 43-21 victory over Brevard College. Wingate now 8-0 all time under Joe Reich against the Tornadoes. In third straight year, Wingate gets 43 points against the Tornadoes one way or the other.
Only I would know that.
Joe Reich, another good win. It was interesting to see how this team was going to bounce back because the emotional win against Catawba had to have it. An option team, they went 14 plays on the first drive. Then the big play, and all of a sudden the defense pinched down, did their job, made the adjustments. What'd you love most about this afternoon?
You know, exactly what you said, the defense coming back after a little inconsistency early in the first couple series, but then to come back and just play lights out. I mean, really tough physical defense, and boy, that's neat to see. And you know, it's nice to see a little physicality. You know, like offensively, we're starting to be able to run the ball more. We're playing physically. You know, Orlando stepping in for Will was huge. You know, Will tried to go, just couldn't go. Hopefully he'll be back next week. But you know, Orlando Cologne coming in and playing, that's huge for us. That's why we brought him in from junior college, to give us some depth and to challenge there. And for him to come in and do the job was great. Kyle just playing effectively. You know, that's what we need. Nestor obviously doing a great job. Micah coming in, giving some good yards as well. So that's a good combination for us, no doubt.
Coach, we talked about how this defense has just gotten better every game. It felt like, you know, good defense go out there and make plays. Great defense pick up loose fumbles and score. They grab those interceptions that are up in the air for grabs. Right. This team has really gotten a knack for the football. Yeah. And, you know, we joke about Coach Jordan begging for it every day, but it looks like it's starting to happen. I mean, 4 today, 6 last week. Yeah. I mean, after only 8 in the first 5 games.
Yeah, that's huge. I mean, we've talked about it before. Turnover margin is the most important statistic in football. So, and we just keep harping. And our guys are just coming up with it. I'd love to tell you that we're doing some great coaching job, but the reality is they're just playing their tails off right now and going after the ball and being ball hawks and scooping it up and scoring. We got some good athletes back there. There's guys that can scoop it up and score. They're not just going to fall on it. You know, Cornell has been playing really consistently throughout. He's had a really good season for us. And it's neat to see that. You know, I think that's under Coach Jordan and under Coach Clark. He's just kind of keeps evolving every week and just playing so solidly right now, no doubt.
Coach talked to Matthew Gibson, and he's a leader, a guy that's been in the role a long time. You said right. Poteet couldn't play. I mean, what a couple of weeks for this offensive line. I mean, people forget these are all redshirt freshmen and sophomores. Right. And Cantrell, a solid day snapping the ball, something that everyone's been keeping an eye on. I mean, you're an offensive line guy. I mean, how proud. I mean, this is just an amazing turnaround for them.
Very. You know, in fact, we have 3 redshirt freshmen in there, in the interior 3. To see those guys step up and take charge of, okay, look, we're gonna start running the ball a little bit more, and we're gonna be physical, and I think we're finding that's what they do pretty well. And then it's helping them in the pass game as well, because now we don't have to sit back and just, you know, the D-line just can't tee off on us. If we're putting ourselves in makeable third downs because we're running the ball effectively, that's going to help them out in pass protection. So it's just it's neat to see that group continue to step up. Greg Isaiah does a great job with those guys. I know he works his tail off to make those guys better every day. So it's neat to see that. And you know, it'll be nice to have Will back. Hopefully he can rehab that ankle and get him back, because he's such a great leader for us. Obviously, Matt Gibson has been phenomenal. But it's nice to have Will back. It'll be nice to have those two guys going back in there and just continue to get better and better inside.
Coach, you learn a lot about a team each week. You know, you learned a lot about that Newberry game. Needed a good week of practice. Back-to-back really solid wins for you guys. As you head into the second half of the schedule, 5-2, already surpassed the win total from last year. Right. It's no longer, you know, let's go out and have a solid season. Let's go out and continue what we're doing. You know, on paper, the schedule in favor, but you got to go out and play every game. I mean,
absolutely.
All of a sudden, you're in the middle of a pack of a region, and, you know, it turned into something special it could be.
Yeah, and there's no doubt. We talked to the team back a while ago after the Newberry loss that we're in playoff mode. I mean, there's no doubt about it. We're in playoff mode. So, you know, every game we got to treat like a playoff game. And we haven't overemphasized that, but we bring it up and just say, look, and I think then the players know that. And they know it's just playoff mode for us. Every game gets bigger. It doesn't matter who we're playing, every game gets bigger. We know Tuscum is quite capable. You know, they knocked off Newberry, a team that we lost to a couple weeks ago or last week. So we know they're capable. I know that, you know, Coach DeBusk is going to have those guys rocking and rolling against us. That he just always does. So every game will be a fight from here on out, no doubt.
Coach, thanks for your time. Great win. We'll see you this week.
Appreciate it. Thanks, Ryan.